The first time I got arrested, I was 18. I got caught like, I knew I had like 80, 90 bags of crack on me. And I was at the Tesco up there. I ran all the way down. I ran for the police. When he came in the store, he was watching me for like a couple of days, watching what I'm doing. So I hid my bomb, my sack of crack or whatever, mm-hmm. in the bushes. And I walked into
you
the
knew
store.
That he was watching you.
I didn't know he was watching.
Okay.
I'm just saying, like, so when I hid in the bushes, I always, like, you come, when I'm in the store, it's so high up there. Wait till you come, then I go get it, boom, then I retreat. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
But this day he was watching me, so when I went to get out of the bushes,
he
saw me, so he pulled up on me. I was just like, that's for my ID. And I was so smart, I gave it to him. Because I know that I'm buying some time, and I had it on me. So I gave it to him, I took off.
So while he was looking at it, you took off?
Yeah, I took off.
And he didn't...
I ran him, but when I ran down here, I didn't know they was watching me. That's somebody I was down there. He knew which path I was going to take. He drove over the car, tried to catch me. And I ran down. I jumped on some high, some very high to the bottom court, from the top court to the, and then my adrenaline hit my legs. I was tired. I couldn't run no more. I just fell down. They just beat me up.
You know? Wow.
So, but the story said, though, when I got arrested, I had to call home. You want to call. So, of course, I had no number. I didn't know the numbers by heart. You can't call a cell phone, collect.
Right.
You got to call your house. That's all I knew. So I called my mom, like, well, I'm locked up. She's like, what you locked up for? I said, locked up for crack cocaine, controlled substance. I said some shit like that.
Uh-huh. Like, control, you tried to give her, give
like,
it a technical
title.
What
they do that for? I said, I don't know. I just stand at the bus stop. I was going to a job interview. She said, I told you about hanging on that bus stop. I said, oh, no, I'm just trying to get a job, mom. And she believed me for a long time.
Did you feel bad?
Yeah, I felt bad.
Because it's weird. It seems like you definitely had, like, I mean, along with a lot of strategic planning that you were doing at a very young age, the fact that you were still going to school and actually cared about whether your mom knew what you were doing or didn't know what you were doing, there was, like, also a conscience there.
Oh, I definitely had a conscience. I never wanted to hustle forever, but it just running rapid so hard in my neighborhood. You know, so much money mm-hmm. and temptation mm-hmm. to compete with all the people, friends, peer pressure. Not peer pressure to do it, but if they do it, and I always say that like a lot of guys who I be with, the people who I didn't like, mm-hmm. they were doing, they weren't smart with it. I saw opportunity.
Yeah.
And what they was doing, that I could do it better and really make some money.
What was the difference between them and you?
I would save my money.
Really?
And they would spend theirs.
You're that young and you weren't buying clothes, getting cars, getting hotel rooms.
I got caught 6 to 7, bought a bags of crack, I paid my own lawyer, bought my own stuff out of jail. I moved out the house because she didn't want me there. From that point on, I was on my own. I got my own apartment. I started rapping. I started putting out my own CDs.
That was the moment
That's the moment when I started rapping. After I went to jail and got out, I continued to hustle, like the day I got out. But then, like 4 or 5 months later, I got locked up for what I had to do. 90 days in jail, in the Cap County jail. And,
so it was that second time that really pushed you?
See, the first time I just got arrested, I brought out the next day.
Okay.
So then when I got a sentence and went to court, I got sentenced for 9 days. The judge said, at the end, I was going to college out my freshman year. He said, I lost my scholarship. So he was like, at the end of this semester, you got to do 90 days. So I did it. And then I went to jail 90 days, so I was writing raps in jail.
And you had never really written before, or you had thought about it, or you were just a fan of the music before?
I could write poems since I was a little boy. Hmm. But that was like early when I was in first, second, third grade. So I knew I always write words in my head all the time, but I never tried to record nothing. So I recorded I wrote like 10 whole songs. And when I got out, I paid for it, and I recorded those 10 songs.
Wow.
I had a rope, you know what I'm saying?
Uh-huh.
Found a guy to make me the beats, I was just on ADATS. I wanted to own my own masters, I wanted to have my own label. My dad's name was Gucci Mane, so I just used his name. I had a whole plan. The 9 days gave me time to think. So when I got out, plan worked instantly. I was doing a lot of things in the neighborhood. And one time I had stole something. Somebody like had a robbery. And I rapped about the robbery. And it was like well publicized. It was not no beef, but then
right,
I had done
right.
it. So I said it. I said it on the wax.
And so everybody that already heard about that incident.
That blew me up ASAP. Just about this neighborhood.
On some reality rap.
I was a legend then, and that fame, I just kept, I ain't want to never lose since that day.
Well, you know, there's always one foot in, one foot out, and I think that a lot of people, a lot of artists learn the hard way by sort of towing that line for as long as they possibly can, you know, where they're hustling and rapping at the same time. But for you, you just quit cold turkey.
Be honest with you. People always ask me what makes me different or why do people do that and what's the difference. I think it's just privilege, the dynamics and the upbringing of a person, what determines who that person is.
Okay.
Whether being a rapper or being an athlete or being a journalist or being the president of the United States. If you was growing up abused, it might mess with your confidence. Me personally, I didn't grow up in a broken home. You know what I'm saying? I didn't grow up in an abusive house. Both of my parents were very hardworking people. I just was, and they used to get me out. I didn't really know if I was poor or not, but I knew I was. Hmm. So, because they gave me what, that's how we live. My mother worked 2 jobs because she wanted kids to have what they wanted when they asked for
right.
it. But she still could satisfy that, like, made a monster out of me.
And instead of, like, you know, a lot of people that you spend it right away, you want to show off, but what made you sort of save all of yours?
I hate to put somebody else in the ground, I know it's about me, but even with my homie Juice, you know, I think the reason we're a lot successful because when I was hustling at a young age, we already was good with money. Not saying that we had so much money, like I was saying, but we was always managing money.
Hmm.
You know what I'm saying? We always had money in case of an emergency for a rainy day. And that's since we were 9, 7 years old, picking up cash. And when our money would get low, we'll go pick up more cash.
Mm-hmm.
And so when we was hustling mentality, he had his own enterprise of OJ the hustling. I had my own enterprise of Coochie Enterprise, which is get up every day and go make some money. You know what I'm saying? Anyways, where I could, I knew that I couldn't never be broke. If I got broke, I got very nervous because I didn't want to look like, not the look of his money.
Right.
People knew me for having money since I was a little boy. I was like one of the most popular guys in my school, that neighborhood.
Uh-huh.
So that was almost a gift and a curse.
As a child, what did you see that the money gave you? It gave you security, it gave you...
Freedom.
To do what? What were you using it for?
Financial freedom. Buy what I want, go where I want, learn about what I wanted. Not even almost peace of mind.